1816 was a very strange year, full of mystery. Many even called it the year of the Little Ice Age, or the year without summer. In Europe, even in the United States, many awaited the arrival of this hot season, but the bright sun had been extinguished. The stars had been turned off in that immense sky. The earth was frozen under a spectral shadow. Most of the villagers were shocked by what was happening. Many thought it was the end of the world. Even in a medallion of the time engraved in Germany said, "Great is the affliction, O Lord, have mercy." It all started at the beginning of May, when the effects were more noticeable, the frost became more intense, affecting the crops. Between July 5 and 10, snowfalls began. For example, in Canada, 30 centimeters of snow were recorded. This strange weather was not only affecting Europe and North America, but also several Asian countries. What was happening to the planet? Why had summer disappeared and most of the world was under a winter season? The answer was to be found in Indonesia. A year earlier, on April 10, 1815, the Indonesian island of Sumbawa witnessed the worst volcanic eruption in modern times. The Tambora volcano erupted, spewed a plume of fire more than 20 kilometers high, and could be heard 2,000 kilometers away. The eruption released nearly 100 megatons of sulfur aerosols into the stratosphere. Initially, this eruption generated strange and spectacular sunsets. The haze caused some of the incoming sunlight to be reflected, causing the earth to cool by half a degree Celsius. Famine ravaged Indonesia due to crop failures, unleashing a cholera epidemic without precedent. In the United States, several lakes and rivers were completely frozen, and crops were also affected. At that time, it was impossible to know the real reason why the planet cooled and darkened. So many thought it was the end of the world. We can also learn how a natural phenomenon, in this case, the eruption of a volcano, can cause so much damage worldwide. Today, the Tambora volcano is still active, and a new major eruption may occur again. Now, the question is, will we be prepared for the consequences of this eruption?